Are your guitar tracks getting a little bit out of hand when it comes to mixing? We'll be checking out how track stacks might be able to help you in Logic Pro 10. Hey guys, you're in the studio with Luke from guitariq.com. Thank you once again so much for joining us. We're here looking at the latest release of Logic Pro, and we're checking out some of the new features from the perspective of a guitar player. Now, as we mentioned today, we are looking at this new feature they're calling track stacks. If you use a lot of MIDI, you're going to find that this is going to be helpful for stacking multiple instruments on top of each other at once. But in this video, we're looking at it from the perspective of a basic mix situation with our guitars. It's going to help us do two things. The first is organize and clean up our sessions. And the second is give us greater creative control when it comes time to mix our projects. So we've already looked at Amp Designer and we've looked at pedal board. And to help us test out some of the new additions, we've been using this basic backing track, which I'll play for you now. So we're just running those guitars through Amp Designer. I have a little bit of a reverse delay happening on that lead line, but that's about it. So to demonstrate track stacks, what I'm going to do is simulate what these guitars might look like in a mixed scenario. So the first thing I might be looking to do is get a little bit more stereo spread in my rhythm guitars. So I've double tracked that. I'm going to send one left and one right. And this is what that sounds like. The second thing I might think about doing is getting a little bit more width in my lead line, helping it sit with the backing guitars a little more. And so I might send it through something like a stereo delay. Here's how that sounds. And the last thing I might do for the purposes of this mix is simulate a more natural sounding room environment around these guitars. So I've sent it through Space Designer, and here's what that sounds like. Now, we're not trying to do anything over the top here. We're just using stock Logic plugins. We're keeping this reasonably straightforward. What I'm trying to demonstrate here is that even a few basic parts, when it comes time to mix our projects, can really start to multiply our track counts. So at the moment, we've ended up here with 5 different tracks for our guitar mix. Now, that certainly looks fairly manageable, but we need to imagine what this would look like if we have drums and bass and acoustic guitars and backup vocals and lead vocals and so on. Our track counts can really start to add up. So what track stacks are going to give us is a way of organizing this really easily. I can come up here, select one track, hold shift, select another. If I right click, I can come down to create track stack. Here I have 2 options. I have a folder stack and a summing stack. I'll just create a folder stack so you can see that. Now that's basically consolidated these down to one single track. I can still access these tracks independently from this drop-down menu here. And you can see the outputs are still set to my stereo out. Everything's as it was, except I can now mute, solo, adjust the volume, and automate the volume of those tracks together at once. But that's sort of all I can do. So if I undo that, say I actually want to create a submix for all of my guitars and have a little bit more flexibility in what I can do with that, I do the same thing, select the top track here, hold shift, select the track at the bottom. Now they're all selected. I right click, press create track stack. Now I come down to a summing stack. If I create that, you can see it's doing a similar thing in terms of I can condense that all down to one track now. But what's happened here is it's changed the output of all of my tracks now to bus 3. So effectively, they're all outputting through this new track that I've added. I can still mute that and solo that, adjust the volume and even automate again. But now I can change the output, I can add different sends, and I can add effects. Now these effects are going to be global effects to all of these tracks. If I want to add some compression to everything, I can do that here. If I want to EQ everything at once, I'm doing that here also. I can select that, rename it, and there I have my guitar submix. Now, say I have my room send here and I want to send some other things through that, you know, so I want to put my drums through that as well. So I don't really want that specifically part of my guitar submix. All I need to do is grab that and drag that out of that track stack. And if I reorganize that now, you can see the output here is again sent to my stereo out. It's not running through this submix. It's independent again. If I then decide later that I've changed my mind and I do want that specifically part of my guitar submix, all I need to do is drag that in. And again, we're outputting that through bus 3 and it's part of my track stack. So that's pretty helpful when it comes to cleaning up our sessions, organizing our audio, and having some extra creative control when it comes to mixing our tracks. So we have the final guitar submix here. As you can see, all of the elements are still there. We have more options for further processing. And if I play that for you now, you'll see sonically everything is unchanged. So that is track stacks within Logic. We're obviously demonstrating this on guitars, but this applies to all elements of our mix. Essentially, even the most complex mixes can be summed down to a handful of basic bus mixes or stems, okay? If you're familiar with mixing, you'll know that this concept isn't anything at all new to mixing. In fact, track stacks don't allow us to do anything that we couldn't do before in terms of sending our audio out and summing it down. What it is offering is a simple, intuitive way to do this, to organize our audio, to clean up the process, and to make things easier for ourselves. So I hope that was able to help you out. That is Track Stacks within the latest release of Logic Pro. Well, that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I'd really love to hear how you guys are using some of these new features in Logic Pro with your guitars when you're tracking and mixing. If you're interested in more content like this, then please check us out at the website, guitariq.com. While you're there, jump on board our mailing list. You can also check us out at Facebook. Like the page, leave some questions and comments for further videos. And lastly, if this video has helped you out today, please show some support for the channel by clicking on the like button, sharing the video with your friends, leaving a comment, and most importantly, subscribing to the channel. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.